So this channel, Minute Videos, just made a video about borderline personality disorder, and they're absolutely full of crap, but doesn't matter. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel is all about mental health, and what I like to do is pull different topics from the YouTube community, try to teach you how to improve your mental and emotional well-being. So for any of that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And I got some exciting news for you. You know my book, Rewire Your Anger? Well, I've been telling you all that I want to do an audiobook, and I kept hitting these, like, weird little bumps and trying to figure it out. Well, I have finally started recording it with my own voice, so I am narrating it, and my editor, Zach, he has been editing it. I'm hoping to have the audio version to you guys either by this weekend or early next week. So make sure you're following me on Instagram and Twitter so you don't miss out. If you're somebody who's been waiting for the audio version of this book, it will be out very, very soon, all right? So anyways, Minute Videos. What is Minute Videos? All right, so Minute Videos, the way they brand themselves is that they take story submissions and then they animate them, right? Well, for those of you who are familiar with the YouTuber Jarvis Johnson, he actually just did a video a few weeks ago or a month ago on one of their other channels, which is owned by the same place that owns Minute Videos, which is called That Happened, all right?
And so I can relate to a lot of what's being said in the video and can say, yeah, no, that aligns with my experience. And the problem is that because this isn't real, there are a bunch of people in the comments like expending their emotional energy and being emotionally manipulated by this fake story where they're like sending their condolences and stuff.
My heart goes out to the little girl and her father.
And all it serves is to add to the comment metrics.
So if you want to learn more about what's going on with this company that owns this, I highly suggest you check out Jarvis's video. I'll link it down in the description. All right, but basically, just in a nutshell, all of these places, what they do is they market themselves as taking real life stories and then sharing them with other people. But through the investigation that Jarvis did, as well as an email that he got, what they're doing is they're hiring writers, okay? They're hiring writers to write stories, and then what they do is they know that animation is a big thing on YouTube, so they find somebody to do some voice acting, and then they animate that story, but they sell them as being real stories, and Jarvis discusses some of the issues with that. Well, I saw that Minute Videos posted a video about borderline personality disorder. YouTube was recommending it to me, probably because I watch a lot of mental health videos. I talk about borderline personality disorder on my channel. So I just sat down with my beautiful girlfriend, Tristan, and we decided to watch this video. And like, they're clearly full of crap, and this clearly isn't a real story. So anyways, let's talk about, is this a problem when it comes to mental health? So first off, the story, quote unquote, starts off by explaining the symptoms of borderline personality disorder, all right? For those of you unfamiliar with borderline personality disorder, there are 9 key symptoms, all right? And in order to be diagnosed with borderline personality disorder, first off, never diagnose yourself. Second off, make sure you see a mental health professional in order to do so. Any of my videos or any videos you see on YouTube, they're just to kind of get the wheels turning and say, oh, this sounds familiar. I can relate to this. So you can go to your doctor or your therapist or psychiatrist or psychologist and say, hey, I have some of these symptoms. What do you think, right? But anyways, they explain the 9 symptoms of borderline personality disorder. And like, as I was watching it, I paused it and I ran over to get my copy of the DSM. I'm like, because it didn't sound right. It didn't sound right, the symptoms that they were saying in the video. So I was following along with the DSM, and like, either A, some of the symptoms that they were explaining weren't one of the symptoms, or B, they were explaining the symptom wrong, all right? So there's definitely an issue with that, all right? So let's say you're somebody who was watching this video to see like maybe if you have a symptom, because they're trying to say you might have these symptoms too, right? But if you're explaining them in the wrong way or not using the proper diagnostic criteria, that can be an issue. You might be struggling with something else. Borderline personality disorder is often misdiagnosed as something else. A lot of people with BPD, they're misdiagnosed with things like bipolar, or they might be diagnosed with anxiety or depression or a variety of different other mental illnesses. This is why it's always important to go see a mental health professional and not just assume that you have a specific disorder, all right? So the next part of this video, they finally got into the part where this guy, the guy sharing his story, is explaining his personal experience with it. One thing that I will mention is that it's interesting that they had a male do this this story. And here's the thing. And I want to make it very clear. It seems like based on what we see with studies and statistics, that more women struggle with borderline personality disorder. But some of the most recent studies actually show that it's pretty even. If not 50-50, maybe like 60% women, 40% men, right? But the thing is, men are less likely to go get help for their mental health or get diagnosed with this type of disorder, all right? So it just was kind of interesting to me that they chose to use a male, since more women actually talk about this disorder or being diagnosed with it, right? But anyways, this dude finally gets to the part where he's talking about his disorder. And there were a few things where he talks about, you know, having the symptoms, and it's kind of relatable. And now one of the things is that he says that he has all 9 symptoms. And he also says something to the effect of, if you even have some of these symptoms, you probably have borderline personality disorder. And that's not true. Like I said, based on the DSM, which mental health professionals go out of to diagnose somebody, you have to have at least 5. So if you were only struggling with 1 or 2 of those symptoms, such as like black and white thinking or impulsivity, if those were the only 2 symptoms you had, you would never, ever, ever get diagnosed with borderline personality disorder, right? So that is actually some misinformation that they're stating in that video. So this next part, when he was talking about a situation that scared him, he's talking about being with his girlfriend, and he went into this dissociative, like, rage. And here's how he explained it.
A few months back, things got out of hand. I blacked out and had a major dissociative event where I actually was someone else, like a split personality.
So those of you who follow my channel and listen to what I say, like, I try to let you know, I am not the person who knows everything. Nobody knows everything. So when I heard of this, because I know what dissociation is, and I know a lot of people struggle with this, but from my experience, my studies, my research, and all of the information I've read, nothing I've ever heard lined up with what this guy was talking about, all right? Like, he explained it like it was somebody else taking over, and, you know, in his dissociative episode, right? And what I did was I went over to the Discord server, join it if you haven't yet, get some support. Anyways, I pinged everybody and I was like, yo, does anybody in here, A, struggle with dissociation? And B, if you do, have you ever gone into like a dissociative rage, right? Where you just like completely disconnected from reality, completely zoned out, if you will, and you just went into this rage and you didn't even remember, right? And everybody who replied to me in Discord said no. And I was like, exactly, right? So it is possible for somebody to go into like a blackout, and it can feel as though somebody else is like controlling them or whatever, but this isn't dissociation, all right? Oftentimes, especially if somebody's struggling with borderline personality disorder, because of the emotional dysregulation, they can get into this extreme form of anger, but they're still present. They're still aware. They are not unaware of what's happening right there. But the problem is like, while they're in that rage, they can't stop. There is no putting on the brakes. There is no dialing back. You see what I mean? So again, this is some misinformation that Minute Videos is putting out there, which doesn't quite line up with borderline personality disorder. And actually, like, to explain to you a little bit more about why this can potentially be dangerous on this platform is because this channel has almost 1 million subscribers. This video has over 100,000 views. And the number one comment on it is this, and they say that they have all 9 of the symptoms. But like we discussed, if the 9 symptoms that Minute Videos just explained about borderline personality disorder are not the correct symptoms, then it is potentially dangerous that somebody is saying that they have it, even though those aren't the correct symptoms. All right. So the last thing, you know, does it matter? Does it matter? Yes and no. For all of the reasons that I've listed, yes, it does matter. But I'm a glasses half full kind of guy, all right? I'm glad that, you know, even though they're doing it in the wrong way, there is a large channel bringing more awareness to an illness like borderline personality disorder, discussing the stigma around it, and they encourage people to get help, all right? So they talk about getting therapy, they talk about medications that might help. I've talked about this in other videos about BPD. There's not a specific medication for borderline personality disorder, but there are medications for symptoms. For example, antidepressants for depression, anti-anxiety for anxiety, and so on. And there's also like mood stabilizers and things like that, all right? So I guess the small little like silver lining of this crappy video with a fake story is that people might actually go out and seek a mental health professional, all right? But let me know down in the comments below, do you find any issue with fake stories about having mental illness? All right, let me know down in the comments, okay? Because they've done some other videos like this, and so has that channel That Happened. So I might do more videos. So let me know what your concerns are. Maybe I'll do some more videos on this, all right? But anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell because I make a ton of videos. And a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And if you would like to get some exclusive videos and get on our group calls or individual calls, click or tap on that Patreon icon right there, all right? Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.